What type of learning outcomes can be achieved through experiential learning activities? Strong course design begins with learning outcomes. What knowledge and application do you want students to solidify most throughout the duration of the course? With these core outcomes or objectives, we can move into the creation of the assignments and activities. Educators must focus their preparations on how and what they will do to deepen and cement this learning. The overarching goal across curricula is to identify where students need to focus on learning foundational theories or concepts and where opportunities exist for these to be brought to life through active and experiential learning. In your course design process, ask yourself these questions. How active and participatory is your course? How relevant to real life is it? What outcomes does it promote?
We're answerable to our course outcomes because they're ministry mandated, and that's the contract we make with students. So any time that there would be an experience that would jeopardize the meeting of those course outcomes, I would say that we'd have to step back and think. I am hard pressed to find an example where you couldn't find an experiential learning method that wouldn't target an outcome. So I that would be a challenge that I would happily meet, but I would find it difficult to ever to find something that I couldn't come up with some way of having students experience something.
I'm a big believer in group work because that is what people will be largely doing when they leave university, regardless of the field they go in. I am a big believer in tying classroom outcomes and classroom activities to what people are going to be doing when they're outside the classroom, because there's little sense in employing pedagogical tools or techniques that bear no resemblance to the so-called real world. And I try and bring that into my other course elements as well. Simulation is one such option. I've mentioned some others in my earlier segments, service learning, and case assignments and client projects, all can fulfill that as well. And I'm sure there are even more creative tools that can be used that I'm unaware of.
In health administration, we learned about different quality improvement processes and methodologies. And in the experiential learning course I equip, I was able to actually apply the theory and the skills that I learned in health administration to my actual project. So making a project, process maps, project charters, working in teams, teamwork skills, motivating other people to want to help in the project, engaging key stakeholders across the health system, and really understanding how the healthcare system works, but also the projects that they might do on an ongoing basis.
And it also is really exciting for us because I think we're kind of, in a Canadian context, probably the first generation of artists at a university that consider our work as research creation. So art is actually a type of research outcome. And we couch it in terms of research, but we know it's a creative response. It's a way of knowing, it's a way of being, and it's a way of producing knowledges and other sorts of outcomes.